CUT&RUN is a versatile in vivo method used to map protein-DNA interactions. CUT&RUN DNA is compatible with next-generation sequencing analysis, referred to as NGS. This video demonstrates the CUT&RUN DNA library prep protocol using the Cell Signaling Technology DNA Library Prep Kit for Illumina systems. Note that this kit is recommended only for Illumina sequencers. This protocol video picks up after purification and qPCR analysis of CUT&RUN DNA. Before beginning, please refer to the CUT&RUN protocol video, section 7, by clicking the link on your screen. Whenever possible, we strongly recommend including qPCR as a quality control step for your CUT&RUN experiments. You can also find answers to frequently asked questions, a troubleshooting guide, links to technical support, and recommended companion products and validated antibodies at the CST CUT&RUN Resource Center. Visit anytime using the links below this video.
When performing DNA library prep, we recommend using as much CUT&RUN DNA as you can obtain, or at least 0.5 to 10 nanograms. While as little as 0.1 nanograms can be used for library prep, this may result in lower diversity of DNA libraries. Quantitation of the CUT&RUN DNA prior to beginning library prep is optional, but can help to determine the optimal number of PCR cycles when amplifying your library DNA. If you choose your quantitated CUT&RUN DNA, a picogram assay is recommended over a spectral photometer such as a nano drop due to the expected low quantity. We recommend using the input DNA from section 5 of the CUT&RUN protocol to generate a control library DNA. 5 to 10 nanograms of input DNA is a good starting point. This control is used to determine if any experimental bias in DNA enrichment was introduced during the CUT&RUN reaction and the library prep. As we mentioned in the protocol considerations, input DNA is preferred over ITG as a negative control, since it generates DNA libraries with higher diversity.
The written protocol for CUT&RUN DNA library prep is included with the kit and is also available on the product page at cellsignal.com. For the purposes of this video, we have broken out the protocol into chapters for end preparation, adapter ligation, cleanup of ligated DNA, PCR enrichment, and cleanup of PCR amplification. You can skip ahead or back using the timeline at the bottom of this video. Materials included in the CST DNA Library Prep Kit for Illumina are listed here. In addition, the adapter ligation reaction requires primer adapters. The CST Library Prep Kit for CUT&RUN must be used with either the CST Single or Dual Index Primer Kit for Illumina systems. Additional materials required are listed here. Let's begin the protocol. Before starting in prep, thaw in prep reaction buffer at room temperature, vortexing if a precipitate is visible, and perform a quick spin of the end prep buffer and enzyme to collect material at the bottom of the tube. Prepare 1x TE buffer as indicated in the protocol. For each CUT&RUN sample and input control DNA, add enough 1x TE to bring the volume to 50 microliters. Make a premix of 3 microliters N-prep enzyme mix per sample and 7 microliters N-prep reaction buffer per sample. Then add 10 microliters of premix to each sample in PCR tubes. Mix each reaction by pipetting up and down or inverting the tube at least 10 times. Perform a quick spin to collect liquid at the bottom of the tube. Place PCR tubes in a thermocycler using the program shown here. Note the lower temperature used for the CUT&RUN DNA compared to the library prep protocol for ChIP DNA. Before the end of the thermocycler program, prepare materials for adapter ligation. Thaw the adapter at room temperature. Mix the ligation master mix by pipetting up and down several times and place on ice. Reserve 2.5 microliters of tris chloride for each sample.
At the conclusion of the end prep program, proceed directly to adapter ligation. Storing samples in the freezer can lead to a loss of yield.
Dilute adapter in tris chloride to avoid contamination of the library with excess adapter. Suggested adapter dilutions are listed in this table. To each 60 microliter in prep reaction, add 30 microliters ligation reaction master mix, 1 microliter ligation enhancer, and 2.5 microliter diluted adapter. Thoroughly mix each reaction by quickly inverting the tube or pipetting up and down at least 10 times.
The ligation master mix is very viscous, and incomplete mixing will result in reduced reaction efficiency. Take care to ensure the reaction is fully mixed. The presence of small bubbles will not interfere with the reaction. The ligation master mix and the ligation enhancer can be premixed ahead of time, as noted in the protocol, but adding adapter to the premix is not recommended.
After a quick spin, incubate the ligation reaction for at least 15 minutes at room temperature. If you will be proceeding directly from adapter ligation to DNA cleanup without stopping, at this time you may begin warming up beads and preparing fresh 80% ethanol and tris chloride as noted at the start of the next section. At the end of the 15-minute incubation, collect user enzyme at the bottom of its tube with a quick spin. Add 3 microliters of user enzyme to the ligation reaction. Mix well by quickly inverting the tubes or pipetting, followed by a quick spin, and incubate for 15 minutes at 37 degrees with the heated lid set to at least 47 degrees. Samples may be either stored at minus 20 or you may proceed directly to the next step, cleanup.
During cleanup of adaptor-ligated CUT&RUN DNA, site selection is not recommended because it reduces both yield and the diversity of DNA libraries. The shortened extension time during step 3 of section 4, PCR enrichment of adaptor-ligated CUT&RUN DNA, is used to exclude large DNA fragments that are incompatible with NGS.
Thaw ligated DNA samples if they were stored in the freezer at the end of the previous section, and prepare ampure or spry select beads by inverting or swirling the bottle, aliquoting the volume of beads needed and allowing them to warm up to room temperature for 30 minutes prior to starting. Prepare fresh 80% ethanol and tris chloride. Add 106 microliters of beads to each adapter ligation reaction. Mix thoroughly by pipetting up and down 10 times or more. Incubate the beads at room temperature 5 minutes or longer. Then place tubes on a magnetic stand for 5 minutes. Carefully remove and discard the supernatant. Remove as much liquid as possible, but do not disturb the pellet. This helps to eliminate free adapter. With the tube in the magnetic stand, slowly add 200 microliters of 80% ethanol to each tube. Incubate for 30 seconds, then carefully remove as much supernatant as possible, again while being careful not to disturb the beads. Repeat step 5 once, for a total of 2 washes. After the second wash, again remove as much liquid as possible without disturbing the beads. With the tube still in the magnetic stand, allow the bead pellet to air dry for up to 5 minutes at room temperature. Have the tris chloride at hand while the beads are drying.
Proceed to the next step when all visible liquid has evaporated, but the beads still have a glossy appearance. If the beads start to crack, they are overdried and may have lower recovery of DNA targets.
To elute the DNA, remove samples from the magnetic stand and add 17 microliters of tris chloride. Then, resuspend the beads in each well or tube by pipetting up and down 10 times. Incubate at least 2 minutes at room temperature. Place the tube on the magnetic stand for 5 minutes. After the solution is clear, carefully transfer 15 microliters of supernatant containing the DNA targets to a new PCR tube. At this point, samples may be stored at minus 20, or you may proceed directly to PCR enrichment. Before starting PCR enrichment of adaptor-ligated DNA, thaw the primers and adapter-ligated CUT&RUN DNA at room temperature and perform a quick spin. Refer to the datasheet for either single or dual index multiplex oligos for Illumina for information on how many primers to use, valid combinations, and tips for setting up PCR reactions.
Always use a variety of primers to increase diversity of barcodes in the final library pool. Be sure to write down the combination of oligos used for each sample.
To each tube of adaptor-ligated CUT&RUN DNA, add master mix and primers as shown in this table. Thoroughly mix each reaction by pipetting up and down or inverting the tube 10 times. If a variable number of PCR cycles are needed for different samples, separate the PCR tubes, then perform a 10-second spin to collect liquid. Place tubes into a thermocycler and set up a program based on the starting quantity of CUT&RUN DNA as shown in this table, which is also included in the written protocol. Please note that the recommended PCR program is different for CUT&RUN DNA compared to ChIP DNA. If you will be proceeding directly to the next section, at this time warm up ampure beads to room temperature for 30 minutes. After the thermocycler program is complete, samples may either be stored at minus 20 or you can proceed directly to final cleanup. Prepare fresh 80% ethanol and trichloride. Resuspend room temperature ampure beads by pipetting up and down or inverting. Then add 50 microliters of resuspended beads to each 50 microliter PCR reaction. Mix well by pipetting up and down 10 times, expelling all liquid out the last time. Incubate the beads at room temperature 5 minutes or longer. Then place tubes on a magnetic stand for 5 minutes. Carefully remove and discard the supernatant, removing as much liquid as possible without disturbing the bead pellet. With the tube in the magnetic stand, slowly add 200 microliters of 80% ethanol to each tube. Incubate for 30 seconds, then carefully remove as much supernatant as possible, again while being careful not to disturb the beads. Repeat step 5 once for a total of 2 washes. After the second wash, again remove as much liquid as possible without disturbing the beads. With the tube still in the magnetic stand, allow the bead pellet to air dry for up to 5 minutes at room temperature. Have the trichloride at hand while the beads are drying. Similar to the drying step in section 3, take care to avoid over-drying the beads. Remove samples from the magnetic stand and add 33 microliters trichloride to elute DNA from the beads. Or use 17 microliters if a higher concentration of library DNA is desired. Thoroughly mix by pipetting up and down several times and incubate at room temperature for at least 2 minutes. Place tubes on the magnetic stand for 5 minutes. After the solution is clear, carefully transfer supernatant to a new tube, using a volume 2 to 3 microliters less than the volume added in step 8. Purified DNA libraries may be either stored at minus 20 or you may proceed to final preparation for sequencing. Quantitate DNA concentration using a nanodrop or picogreen assay. The concentration of the DNA library should be in the range of 10 to 40 nanograms per microliters. Dilute 1 microliter of the DNA library to a final concentration of 5 to 10 nanograms per microliter. Determine the size distribution of the library using a bioanalyzer or an equivalent instrument. Check for the presence of adapters which will contaminate the sequencing reaction. If adapter dimer is observed, repeat cleanup steps 1 through 10 to remove adapter monomer and dimer. Before sending the final purified DNA libraries to a sequencing facility, dilute them with trichloride to the same nanomolar concentration. Then pull the libraries together.
Compare the peaks of your CUT&RUN samples to the input DNA traces, which indicate the non-specific binding. Many of the bioinformatics tools used for ChIP-seq data analysis can also be used for CUT&RUN NGS analysis. In addition, other tools such as the peak calling program seeker are available for CUT&RUN bioinformatics.
This concludes the DNA library prep protocol for CUT&RUN. Should you have any questions that were not addressed in this video or on the CUT&RUN resource page, if you need help troubleshooting your CUT&RUN experiment, or if you have any questions about a CST antibody, please visit cellsignal.com/support. This will connect you directly to the scientists who develop the DNA library protocol and who validate cell signaling technology antibodies and kits.